This is my second example in which I'm calculating the cross rate between two currencies. What we are given here is the following. $1 equals 32 Thai baht. Baht is the currency in Thailand. And we also have 1 ruble, which is the currency in Russia, equals 2 US cents, so 0.02 US dollars. So this is the information that's given to us, and we need to use it to calculate the cross rate between the baht and the ruble, which are both foreign currencies. The domestic currency is the US dollar, but we are looking for the implied exchange rate, which is what the cross rate means, between two foreign currencies, the Thai baht and the Russian ruble. I would recommend to start with the following. In my other example, example number one on calculating the cross rate, which you can also watch, which is actually a little bit easier than this one, we have both exchange rates between the dollar and the foreign currencies expressed in terms of $1 equals the amount of that foreign country's currency. So why don't we take the one for the Russian ruble and rewrite it that way? So let's take this one and first rewrite it as follows. So we wanna have $1, right? How do we have get $1 when we have $0.02 right now? Well, we need to divide by 0.02. And we do that division for both sides of this exchange rate. So we take ruble 1 and divide it by 0.02. And we do the division by 0.02 for the right-hand side as well, where we currently have 2 cents, right? So 0.02 US dollars is also divided by 0.02. And what we get is the following. On the ruble side, when we divide 1 by 0.02, we get 50. And on the dollar side, where we have 0.02 divided by 0.02, the 0.02 both cancel out, and we are left with just $1. So let's switch sides. So this is the same as $1 equals 50 Russian rubles. And so the reason we did these first three steps is only so that the exchange rate between the dollar and the Russian ruble looks similar to the exchange rate that we are given between the US dollar and the Thai baht. Both start with $1 equals on the left-hand side, right? And so we take, you know, the exchange rate for the dollar and the baht, and then the exchange rate between the dollar and the ruble, and put them together. So now it's as if we are given the following. $1 equals 32 baht, and $1 equals 50 rubles. So this is what is now given to us, right? We kind of rewrote it so that it's easier to work with these numbers. And just like in my first example, in my other video, because both 32 baht and 50 rubles equal $1, we can set these two amounts equal to each other. So we can write baht 32, right? 32 Thai baht equal 50 Russian rubles, ruble 50, right? So this is what we can write, right? Kind of to simplify what we are given. And then just like in my other video, we can go two different directions from here. The first direction is we can divide both numbers in this statement, in this equality, by 32. So we have baht 32 divided by 32. Sorry, 32. And that equals 50 rubles, also divided by 32. So 32 and 32 on the baht side cancel out, and we are left with baht 1, so just 1 unit of the Thai baht currency, equals, and then on the Russian ruble side, we have 50 divided by 32, which equals 1.56. And this is the first way of writing the cross rate between the baht and the ruble. And now let's see what else we could do instead. Instead, we can also divide both 32 baht and 50 rubles by 50, right? So we have baht 32 divided by 50 equals 50 rubles divided by 50. Again, on the ruble side, 50 on in the numerator and 50 in the denominator cancel out, and we are left with, on the Thai baht side, we have 32 divided by 50, which gives 0.64, and on the Russian ruble side, we have 1, right? 1 ruble. And this here is the second way of writing the exchange rate, or the cross rate between the baht and the ruble. So again, to clarify, we calculated the cross rate two different ways. They're both equivalent. So we have two ways of writing the cross rate between the Thai baht and the Russian ruble.